One final wide receiver to get to, Frank, and it's another one of your guys, and that's Dante Pettis, who had the draft pedigree, and now he's turned it into real-world statistics. Over the past couple of weeks, he's gotten the job done, including that big goal line touchdown this past weekend for San Francisco. The Niners, like we said earlier, they face the Seattle Seahawks. Tough matchup. Is Pettis usable?
Tough matchup, Gregg, but do you remember what happened last time he faced the Seattle Seahawks in Seattle? That was 5 receptions for 129 yards and 2 touchdowns. He flashed his explosive ability, what he could do after the catch in that game. He had 69 yards after the catch in that game alone, so makes big plays once he gets the ball in his hands. And I referenced this last week as well when it came to Pettis. I was not worried about Marquise Goodwin because even with Goodwin in the lineup, Dante Pettis led all wide receivers on this team with 85% of the snaps. So he was on the field the most. And just looking at the style of play when it comes to Nick Mullins, that does not support a player like Marquise Goodwin. All year that Nick Mullins has been starting, he targets guys over the middle of the field. Why do you see George Kittle getting so much done? Why do you see Dante Pettis? He targets his slot receivers. He targets his tight end. Dante Pettis fits right in the mix. He plays slot wide receiver for this team. Marquise Goodwin, more of the outside wide receiver, a guy that could stretch the field. That doesn't necessarily fit the play style of Nick Mullins. And look at what he's done the past 4 weeks. He's had at least 6 targets in 4 straight games, so giving you a safe floor in terms of opportunity. Has 4 touchdowns in his last 3. He's making plays, and I love that in week 14, they're down on the goal line. They basically told Dante Pettis, one-on-one coverage. You need to go out there and win on the 1-yard line. We're going to throw you the ball. You need to be open. What did he do? He did exactly that. He scored a touchdown, and when you do that, you earn more trust, not only from your quarterback, but from your coaching staff. I don't care that he's playing Seattle in week 15. He just torched them. I am all in on Dante Pettis. Gregg, I might even dye my hair and do a little Dante Pettis thing. What do you think about that?
I'm looking forward to seeing just that, Frank. I'm looking forward to it. Dante Pettis is going to be a very popular name next year with fantasy owners, with Jimmy G back in the fold. You're going to have Marquise Goodwin to go deep. You're going to have Dante Pettis across the middle. Really popular name in the future, and a really popular name in week 15 if you're desperate at wide receiver.